After the success of Donkey Kong, Nintendo had a hit on their hands. The iconic Jumpman of Mario, named after Mario Segale, was due for a follow-up. And Miyamoto had an answer. One of those great titles was Mario Brothers, released for arcades in 1983. Mario Brothers introduces the long-standing character and brother of Mario, Luigi. The object of the game is to attack enemies, flipping them over and touching them after to kill. Once the phase is complete, the game begins to get harder. Although simplistic in design, it was fun and has been recycled in many games since, including Super Mario Bros. 3, Super Mario Bros. Deluxe, and the Super Mario Advance titles. There are four unique enemies in the game, and elements increase the difficulty, such as fireballs that bounce throughout the stage. This game helped establish Mario as an Italian plumber in New York. Before then, he was mostly known as Jumpman. The no-fall damage was introduced in this game as well, at request of Gunpei Yokoi. The suggestion to have hitting the bottom of the floors hurt the enemies, hurt the new turtle enemies, was also Yokoi's idea. Having to touch the enemy after flipping them over was added by Miyamoto because he thought it would be too easy to kill them from below. The justification for this was the fact that the enemies were always intended to be damaged from below and upside down, their bottom is up. Mario Brothers was ported to the NES and it is often hit with mixed reviews. The shortcomings of the port show through when compared to the original arcade release. The downgrade was likely a result of lack of resources as Nintendo was working on titles such as Super Mario Brothers, The Legend of Zelda, and Metroid. But still, it is a fun experience that I would say is an easy way to play a classic. Although the game was never considered a major success, it did establish traits that Mario would carry for decades to come, such as being a plumber and being Italian. The game is a historical piece, and looking back at it, it is just as fun of a game that was one of many stepping stones between Donkey Kong and Super Mario Brothers. It is a solid 7. Thank you guys for watching. Stay nerdy.